All right, welcome everybody. Today we're going to talk about UI and preferences here. So let's just kind of go around the screen. If you go up to the upper left-hand corner, you're going to find your basic menu. And with you can do new scene, it'll clear it out, open, import, and append. So you can have a project open and append another item into it. So that's kind of cool. Export save as, so you can export your models out. You can save this as a startup scene, preferences, manage your license, tells you what version you're on, what file you're using right now. Let's go into preferences here. Navigation is your top selection. You can select which one you want to use, whatever you're familiar with. I tend to be more Blender because that's the way I learned it. So performance, you can change it to... there's not a whole lot. If you have an older device, you can lower the quality. CPU faceted quality, you can hit extra detail, but it's not as fluid. So keep it down at normal. Most of these, you have to restart plasticity currently. So just keep that in mind. Appearance is kind of fun. You can change your accent colors here. Blue, you can see all the icons changing, whatever. Pink, if you want to go pink, that's cool. We'll go back to orange. You can change your neutral colors, just kind of keep an eye on everything. The background or the screen and the dialogues will be that color, whatever you want. You can, let's get back to color. There we go. And you can change your viewport backdrop here, because Plasticity currently doesn't export any images. So if you want to do like a screen grab and you want to use some compositing tricks, you can just click on this and find, say, like a color you don't have in your scene. You know, we'll just go red, as you can see there. So we'll go back to, where were we? Yeah, about there. Okay, grids and units. You can change it to centimeters, meter, inch, foot, millimeter. Change your grid size. Accent lines every 1 centimeter. So if you change it to meter, it'd be every 1 meter. So and so on. So let's go ahead and get out of there. Come over to the left panel here. This is all your items inside a plasticity. You have solids, which is this guy here. You have curves, which is this guy here. You have sheets, which I don't have any, so let's go down here and I will create a solid, and then I'll just copy this, which would be Shift D, and I copied a face or a sheet, as you can see, sheet. Okay. Just delete all that. Control Z. Get out of that. All right. So, continuing on here, we have folders. You can select anything on the screen and hit Control G or hit this button here, and it'll put it into a folder. It will divide the folders into solids or curves. You can see this empty down here, which is the plasticity logo here. Probably won't be in the file that you download, but you can reference any image you want. If you hit M, cancel. It's just whenever you import, you can import a JPEG ping for a reference image there. And if you change the image, it'll actually stay. It'll update, which is kind of cool. So let's move over to the right side here. You have your snap to grid. You can set how often it snaps. I tend to keep it off. You can enable snapping, and you can select all of these here, face, curve, or edge. Turn that back off. Construction planes. Construction planes are basically, if you go here, this is a construction plane on the based on the X, Y, and Z coordinates. So you got your X, Y, you got your Y, Z, and X, Z. You can also do planes from selections and or cameras. And you can see the corresponding shortcuts that it shows for control space, control shift space. So down here is just some preferences here. I'm not sure if that'll be in the final software. That's just the developer checking on how fluid it is, but it can do about 60 frames a second. So like I said, he stripped out a lot of the technical stuff in other software to make it that fast. So it's really fluid. We'll come over here to this panel here. You got basically a line, a curve, center circle, polygon, spiral, corner, and so on. We got some solid objects down here. So, and we got a few things down here, some quick commands. So a lot of things are hidden inside of Plasticity. So if you ever need to figure out what a command is, just hit F on your keyboard, and you can scroll through all the different commands inside Plasticity. So I will do a bunch of short videos kind of going over a lot of these and what they're doing. Just a quick, easy reference for you, so this way you don't have to sit through a large tutorial, which I'm trying not to do. So that is basically it. Let's go back up to our top corner. As you can see, you got your box. You can select this box and get different sides. You can also do, if you hold down Alt and do your middle or whatever your rotation is, get quick orthographic views. You can also disable that if you want. You can do x-ray mode. You can see through everything, which is kind of cool. It's easier to select things. You got perspective, and a lot of these you can right click on them. You can change your field of view. We'll just do 35. Turn off perspective here, turn off x-ray. You got your render mode over here. So we've got a couple different matte caps in here. This is the one I'm currently using. You can do a red here. This kind of helps you see what's going on with your curves to make sure they're not, if they end up not being smooth, you can check that. Other good ones here are the lines. You can do different directions there to see how it's kind of trippy. Sorry, guys. Then you also got this matte cap here. You could do show edges, or you could turn off edges and faces. You could do like a wireframe mode. That's kind of cool. So a bunch of different little things in here. Or you could just left click. Hold on. Just left click. And turn faces back on, and this is the rendered view. And this uses materials, which I'll go over. So that is basically it in a nutshell. All of these things are intuitive, so if you do select it, you'll see extra controls pop up. And then everything is very intuitive. So say like I have a curve selected, so, and I've got extra things that I could do with it. So keep an eye out on that. You'll see a bunch of different options. Let's do Shift A, another line. You can even do Shift Tab. Yeah. And say like I only want a 4 centimeter line. It'll keep it at 4 centimeters. See? Left click to confirm and right click to execute the whole command. So that's basically it for your UI and preferences. There is probably a little more lengthy than you would have liked, but I will see you in the next video, and we'll keep on going.